I'm dreading telling Christina that Maria might be stealing clients, but I have to tell her and I have to do it now because we need to figure this out today. Christina, we need to talk to you for a second.
What's up?
So yesterday was like a bit of uncomfortable situation. I had a first-time client. When she was leaving, Maria came up to her and slipped a piece of paper into her pants.
Okay.
So, you know, we don't know what the paper said.
We're assuming that it was to, like, do the client at home.
I would never think that Maria would do something like that to me. Maria's not like that at all.
We have it on video to prove it to you that, you know.
Okay. Let's see it.
We don't know what to do. I mean, I just told Anthony what Sandra told me, and that's all I know.
It looks like sneaky a little. Seeing Maria pass the client the note, I had a pit in my stomach. If it is her name and number, she can potentially be trying to service the client at home, and that's unethical. It's a big no-no in the salon world. But she's been with us since the beginning. Like, she...
That's exactly...
I just thanked everyone the other day for being so loyal to me.
Okay, but you have to remember, people's loyalty is when it's convenient. Christina does tend to see the good in people, but... I have noticed that Maria's clients don't tend to come back after the first visit, so maybe she is stealing them to do them at home.
I honestly feel like the only way to find out would be to call the client, because this is a serious accusation. I have to find out for sure what was on the piece of paper, because I can't just make assumptions. I have to give Maria the benefit of the doubt. What if it was a restaurant?
It wasn't a... Christina, come on.
A recommendation of something. I want to make sure of it. Hi, Elvira. This is Christina from Olivia Christensen Salon. I'm really, really sorry to bother you in the middle of the day like this. I just have to ask you something. I know that you came in the other day and you had your hair done with Isabella. I was just notified that another stylist slipped a piece of paper into your pocket. Can I just ask what was on the piece of paper?
I knew it. I have such a feeling.
Okay, thank you so much. I'm really sorry to bother you. Bye-bye. It was, yeah.
I mean,
it was her name and number.
That's crazy.
I want to give her a chance to just explain herself.
No, absolutely.
I mean, listen, you definitely have to give her the opportunity to explain herself. She's not going to tell the truth.
I have to confront Maria, and I know that it can't wait. It has to be done. Let's go. I'm scared, I'm nervous, and I'm enraged at the same time. Maria, can I talk to you
for
a minute? But I'm gonna give her a chance to explain herself.
It was brought to my attention about something that went on in the salon, right under my nose. I wanna ask you about it, and I want you to be very honest with me. Did you hand Bella's client a piece of paper? And if you did hand her a piece of paper, what was on the paper?
Yesterday?
Yes.
I give to her one phone number, not my phone number. Okay. It's not about her and about.
So I figured you were gonna say something like that, and I actually took it upon myself to call the client, and she said that it was your name, Maria, with your number, and that you told her that you can do her hair at home.
No, I swear not home. I didn't say for home for nothing.
It's even more upsetting that Maria has been at the salon since day one. And while we've been trying to build her clientele, she's been trying to take the clientele with her.
Do you want to see on camera what you're doing? And it's sneaky. I'm going to play the video for you.
No, I didn't say no. I didn't say no. I give to her.
I give Christina all of my respect for being able to give Maria the chance to explain her way out of this. I'm not that kind of person. I would have been done from the second I heard it.
All I want you to do is own up to what you did. Just admit it.
Okay, I did, but I did.
You did what?
I did that, you say.
Are you taking clients from the salon at home? Just admit that you made a mistake. Please.
Listen to me. I swear,
I don't want to fire you, Murray.
I know. Listen. I'm telling you the truth.
I don't believe you.
I'm the kind of person where I think that everyone deserves a second chance. And if Maria can apologize to me, maybe I would keep her on.
It's okay. I have my hands.
You do have your hands and everyone else's clients.
If Maria can't apologize to me, that's betrayal. And I would never be able to trust Maria ever again.
You have 15 years experience. You should know firsthand. That's the number one thing of what not to do, is to slip your number to a client. Yet you can't even apologize. If you don't apologize to me, do not come back. We've been sitting here and you haven't said sorry to me. You owe me an apology.